Sometimes you just feel tired, feel weak. And when you feel weak, you feel like you want to just give up. But you gotta search within you. Try to find that inner strength and just pull that shit out of you. And get that motivation to not give up and not be a quitter. No matter how bad you want to just fall flat on your face.
So I collapse, I'm spilling these raps long as you feel them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I am not hip-hop, and I'm just not feminine.
Hey, who's there? I am Deathwing. I will be presenting something on how to become a writer today. That's my job, and that's what I'm gonna be doing. So, let's go ahead and get straight into it. This is going to be very interesting. I can tell you that much. I'm lying. If you don't know that, I'm definitely lying. This is not very interesting, but we will have to do what we have to do here. So, let me just get it up. By the way, this is basically probably going to be unedited. So, you're seeing unedited footage right now of my first time doing this presentation. So, that's pretty nice. Let's go ahead and get in. So, Becoming a Writer by me. Yeah, I'm also Deathwing. I'm usually Deathwing. That's my other name. Okay, let's just get it. Basics of becoming a writer. A writer is obviously someone who writes. I wonder how. I don't know where I was going with that. Different forms of writing. Newspaper articles, books, TV scripts, poetry, plays, sports articles, ads. There are so many different ways to write. So many. Many, many more than this. But these are some of the more main ones. It can be either nonfiction or fiction. At least that's how I'm separating it in this presentation. It is a bit more complicated than that. But in general, it's basically nonfiction and fiction. Yeah. Nonfiction versus fiction. So here I'll explain it a little bit better. Nonfiction writes facts about people or events. A few common writing forms are journalists, newspaper articles, or sports articles. Usually writes for a business is, and that means that they are hired. Writes based on what the business wants, not what they want to write about necessarily. So usually the business will give them a topic to write about. Mm-hmm. Fiction uses imagination to write. You got novelists, playwrights, poets, TV scripts, those are all examples. They usually write whatever they want, which is just what I want to do, because I like writing what I like writing. Basically, weird meatball stories and stuff to do with rabbits and, you don't want to know about that. Let's move on. The basics. Here's just a few basic things about it. Any gender is allowed, any age is allowed, any physical or health state is allowed. You just need a computer or a pencil to write. Can work from anywhere, including at home. There's usually no set schedule, although there can be. If you're working for a business, they may set deadlines, so you need to be careful about that. And if you're a fiction writer, sometimes if you're really popular, they can set deadlines for books. Usually, however, there is no set schedule, especially if you're working on your own. And you can start independently. You don't technically have to be hired, although if you're writing for a business, you do have to be hired pretty much. Skills needed. Woohoo. Understanding of grammar and spelling, obviously. You need to understand how to use the English language or whatever language you're writing in. You need creativity. You also need uniqueness, your own ideas. Uniqueness is very, very important because, while that relates more to fiction than to nonfiction, if you want your book to get out there and you want people to like your book, being unique is a major thing because people want to read something they've never read before. Just like that yellow umbrella is unique to all the black umbrellas. If you were choosing an umbrella, you'd probably choose the yellow umbrella because it's different. You want to choose something unique, and that's why uniqueness is very important. And I already passed creativity, but creativity is important as well because you have to be creative to write a fiction book. In nonfiction, you still have to be creative in some ways, like the ways in which you present the information, but generally it's more fiction versus nonfiction in that sense. You need to have an understanding of technology and how to use it to write. You could technically write on paper, but who does that anymore? It's so much easier to write on a computer. You should just use the computer, use Microsoft Word or Google Docs. It's so much easier, and you need to understand how to use that, though, to write really well on it and to write fast. That's very important, so just keep that in mind. The salary. So the salary is something that varies very, very greatly. It just depends on your success in the career. In general, between $30,000 and $119,000 annually, and that's for both nonfiction and fiction. Likely will need another job to support yourself in the beginning if you're a fiction writer. If you're a nonfiction writer, you're getting hired by a business to write. You're not writing your own things, and so you probably aren't going to need that as much, another job. But if you're writing independently, you definitely are going to need another job. And they're mainly paid, your writers are mainly paid in these ways. They're hired by a business with a flat rate. They're paid by a publishing company for rights to your novel. They earn percentage off of sales, or paid per words or hours worked, which is called freelance writing. So just keep in mind that the salary varies greatly depending on your success. If you're nonfiction, you're probably going to have a normal salary like anybody else. If you're fiction, it depends only on your success. You could get a lot of money, you could get no money. Degrees. So no degree or education is required. Oh my gosh. This thing has been on the bottom of my screen. This screen app, the IO sharing screen. I am sorry about that. It's gone now. Don't worry. I'm very sorry. No degree. Let's just move on. Forget that ever happened. Degrees. No degree or education is required to become a fiction writer. Nonfiction writers usually will need a degree. It could be an associate's degree, a bachelor's degree, a master's degree, or a PhD in writing. Any of those would work, but usually businesses would want to hire people with degrees. While not always necessary, taking courses could be a great way to create ideas and sharpen writing abilities. That is definitely true. If you need help getting started, or you need to work on a certain part of writing, like your description, well, that could be a great way to better yourself in the sense of writing. Publishing. Nonfiction is where the business publishes. With fiction, you can either self-publish or publish with an agent. Self-publishing means you won't get in with the big publishers who could promote your book better. You still could. If you're self-publishing, they could maybe come and pick up your book afterwards or something, but if you're self-publishing, you're self-publishing, so you're not going with one of the big publishers, so that could be a good thing, could be a bad thing. Agents can get you in, possibly, with the biggest publishers, getting you better deals, and, yeah, they can also get you better deals. It sounded a little weird right there, but they can get you better deals, and by getting in with the bigger publishers, those publishers, then people who follow them will then want to buy your book more because you got published with an important publisher, showing that you're a real book, and that will get you more sales probably. However, agents do take a commission, usually around 15%, so that's a lot, but self-publishing is just tough because if you don't promote your book well, nobody's ever going to find it, and agents can get you in with the publishers, and then the publishers we'll put your book out there, and that will be how people find your book. Yeah. Okay. Writing is done in almost all cases, done alone in almost all cases, which I can like a lot. Hours of work vary based on how fast and what you write, so there is no set hours. Really, I mean, if you can write fast, you can have like 3-hour days, and that can be your job. I mean, that's pretty amazing. You can just stream Breaking Bad at night or something. I don't know what you want to watch, but I want to watch Breaking Bad. And just fiction doesn't require experience. Nonfiction can require experience, but doesn't necessarily. And all writing, and this is very important, requires knowledge. Nonfiction is obvious because if you're writing about something, you have to have knowledge about it. But fiction does require information as well. Even in the small things, such as what certain knife is called, if you're writing a story about an assassin, that'd be nice. Must be correct, or else someone will notice it can very well destroy your entire book, because nobody will want to read it with mistakes, right? Maybe one grammatical mistake would be fine, but if you have a mistake like that, especially if it keeps showing up, people aren't going to want to read that book. It's unprofessional. Yes. Having your facts correct is massive, and that's why knowledge is massive. Creative a book, even if it isn't real, it's not following a real place, will probably have real things in it. And knowing about that is important. If you can create a book with nothing real in it, that would be, like, amazing. It'd be, like, the first time that's ever happened. Anyway, that is the end. Pretty short presentation, around 10 minutes. It's pretty nice. I suspect that the intro was probably your favorite part, although it's kind of cringy, I'm not gonna lie. Sources, so on the left, those are my image sources. On the right, those are my information sources. And that is the end, and there's a nice turkey I have there. It's very nice. I would love to have a turkey like that, I'm just saying. But yeah, that's about it. Hope you were disappointed that there wasn't more editing in the middle of the presentation. I just didn't know what to do. That's just for, you know, it's fine, yeah. Hope you enjoyed this presentation. Writing, hope you know how to become a writer, know some of the basics. Wasn't going too deep into it. In a presentation, I didn't want to make it too long, and I didn't feel like you got the basics here. You could go deeper into that, but the basics are here. That's how to become a writer in general. That's really all you need to know. Writing is a pretty simple career. There's not much you need to do or not do. You just need to think about these things and what I said. Not gonna go back through them. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So, hope you enjoyed. See you later.